Good morning, everybody. Phil here at Freedom Prospecting. Guess what? We finally got some snow. Not a lot, but we got a couple inches here. By the end of the day, there might be enough to plow. Anyway, it's a little chilly out here, so we're going to go in the gold shop, and we got something special going on this week. Well, Al worked a little bit this weekend. Get this all set to put together right so we could test it out today. So Al, explain what you done.
Okay, it was a little bit of trial and error, but what we basically ended up doing, we found out the shaker deck, it shook too hard, and to eliminate that, I've done some real easy stuff to do. Really, we used bungee cords, tied the legs back on bungee cords back, so it takes everything out, it holds directly to the table. Same thing here. Nuts and bolts, we put lock nuts on there, quarter inch lock nuts, so they can't come loose, because we were finding out it was popping nuts right off the side of it with the vibration. And we had a little bit of noise here, so basically all I did was took a bungee cord, went down, took the pressure right off of it, and she runs really quiet and hopefully very efficient now. So I'm going to turn this back to Phil, and he's going to run the damn thing, and we'll see what happens.
Okay, we'll run some material through and see what happens. We're starting off with this waterfall. A little bit of a glare there, but good band thrown in there.
They call it first settings, we only have 30 volts on here.
Yeah, that's our setting for our vibration.
Out here, get a real good view. They're pretty bad right there.
Oh yeah, look at dancing in there. Should be dropping all the fine gold off in there and washing all your light stuff.
Even at your ripple, look at your ripple here.
Oh yeah. Looking good. So we're going to run maybe a bucket here. We're going to test some of our tailings and see if there's any gold in our tailings. We'll be right back. Look at that dancer on it. That is working good.
She's really rolling,
right? Yep. The Geo High Banker up here hasn't got the vibrator hooked up to it at all. But it's vibrating a little bit because it's the table right down here to get some vibration in it. So I can see it. I can feel it up here. I can feel the vibration in it. So that's also working up here. Any light stuff might be dropping right in these ripples up here before you even get down there. Okay, we shut it off. We ran, we got about 2 gallons of tailings here that we ran into a bucket off the end of the sluice. And we're going to classify it down through the kitchen strainer, put it on the hex mat, then to the milling table, see if there's any gold in those tailings. hopefully there's no gold in here, or very little. So we'll see what happens. Okay, we classified that down to 20 mesh. So we got right around a half a bucket, a little bit more of a 2 gallon bucket left out of the tailings, which started out at 2 gallons. So we're gonna go to the hex mat now. Okay, we got the hex mat running here. Got our tailings. We're going to run all the tailings through here, and then we're going to clean the mat out and run it on the miller table so there's any gold on those tailings. Now you see how that stuff comes down here and just cleans out. That hex mat just cleans that stuff right out of the mat. And it leaves it just the gold in there. Just very fine, little bit of cons left when you're done. See how it cleans out those cells? Hopefully there's no gold in this run. These are our tailings from that sluice with a vibrator.
Down here too?
Okay, we got the mat all run through the mat and we shut it off. And we did see some gold here. Right there's a piece. Not a lot, but there is some. And I think that happened when as I was feeding it, at one point Al told me I was should slow down because I was overloading the sluice. And
themselves weren't cleaning all the way out.
Yeah, they weren't cleaning out fast enough. So we'll put it on the miller table and see exactly how much is in there. Hey, we got the miller table started up. See what kind of cons we got left out of that 2 gallons of stuff we ran, tailings that we ran through the hex mat. See what we got in there. That's all we got left. Not seeing anything yet. Right here. No gold there. Okay. Might have one right there. Two of them. Really tiny stuff. Two tiny ones there. Nothing that time.
You know, I didn't think I'd ever say this, but not to see gold on here is kind of goofy in my mind here.
Yeah, we don't want to see gold
on
here.
I said one time we don't want to see it.
And there's a piece right there. Really tiny. That's got to be 200 mesh. Because I got the magnification turned up on my phone here. Yeah. Nothing in that scoop.
Anything?
Nothing in that scoop. Nothing again. So it's looking good. Nothing gold.
It looked like it for a second.
There's a piece we saw in the hex mat when we shut the water off. There's the other big piece we saw in the mat when we had it shut off. Okay, we got about three or four tiny micro gold out of that. So small I couldn't see it with a naked eye. With a phone magnified on it, we could see it. So that was really tiny stuff. But we got two bigger pieces. It was probably like a 20 mesh. And we saw those in the mat before we cleaned it out when we shut the water off. So out of 2 gallons of material, that's all we got out of there. So, and it could be because there was one point where I was feeding it too fast, and Al says, you better slow it down because it's overloading the riffles a little bit. So I slowed it down and did the rest of it at a slower speed. So if that's the cause of getting those two pieces of gold in there, I think we got something here, piece. Out of that was probably a total of 3 gallons, almost 3 gallons of material we ran through there and checked the tailings out, and that's what we got, just those two pieces and those couple little micro pieces. So that tells me that mat right now is full of gold in there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna clean that big mat out, out of the geosluice and the Black Mamba mat, and we're going to run that through the hex mat again and then on the military and see how much gold is actually caught. So we'll be right back. Okay, we're cleaning the geosluice out first. And then we do the Black Mamba mat. Make sure it's good and clean. Pretty good. We're gonna just run this off the sluice here.
That's where the hidden stuff is.
Yeah. And we'll run that through the kitchen strainer onto the hex mat and on the miller table just like we did with the tailings. So we'll see how much gold we actually caught compared to how much we lost. Be right back. Al brushed the mat out so all the air bubbles are out. That's what we got left after cleaning the mats out. Thank you. I like how it just clears that stuff right out of the hex cells and leaves only the gold. Okay, we'll just run the rest of the stuff and see what we got. Okay, we shut the water off, ran all that stuff through here, and see what we got in here. There's a piece. There's some pieces there. Right there. Got some gold in there. There's some more there. Got the glare in there, but you can see them. Well, no more when we get on the miller table, how much? Okay, we're going to the miller table. Nothing on the first scoop.
Little baby one right there. You see it?
Oh yeah, right there. Another scoop. There's a couple pieces there.
And right there. Oh, another nice one there. In the pile.
There's a nice piece of gold right there. Nice one. There's a nice piece. There's one there. There's some more. Couple there. Really small one. Couple more pieces of micro gold there, really small.
Okay, put them up in your drawer. Up and down.
Oh, there it is. I couldn't find it.
That's
a big piece of gold.
You couldn't see that one? That's a big one.
Yeah, that's a nice piece
of
gold.
Look at that.
Wow.
I just put my finger in there so you can tell how big it is.
Yeah. Couple pieces right there. Three. Pretty decent sized ones there. Couple more down here. About five or six, seven, eight. Oh, here's another big piece. Here's a big piece right there. Right there.
Don't let it get away.
That's a nice one there.
Oh man,
another big
that.
Piece there.
Oh, look at that one.
That's nice.
Oh, this is all on a 3 gallon.
There's two pieces right there, decent size. Some more up there. Some not a piece of micro gold in here. That's what our objective was with the vibrator. Catch that really fine stuff. There's some there. Yep, that's a bigger one there. Nice piece there. There's a couple nice chunky pieces.
Maybe down there. Get this.
Three of them here. Micro gold down here. Oh, here's another nice piece, two more nice pieces.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
Yeah, nope, a couple more in there. Nice. Couple pieces in there. Couple nice ones there. Over here is a whole bunch of them. Up there. A lot of these micro gold in here now. We're getting a lot more of that finer stuff. I think that's from the vibrating. Nice big one there. Look at that one.
Nice chunky gold.
Lots of micro gold. Lots of micro gold. So the vibrator is catching a lot more of that micro gold than we were catching before without it. We're getting some good gold out of this, just 2 gallons of material. This is from Summit Creek.
Yep.
It's a new creek that we went and got some stuff out of this fall and brought it in the shop here, and that's going to run a bunch of it now. Look at that. Gold all around the table. And a lot of pieces of gold in there.
It's amazing.
Yep. I think there's gold in that rock. A lot of pieces in there. Pretty nice one. Some there. Pretty nice one. Lots of micro gold on the table.
A lot of them.
Get so much micro gold on there that you can barely see with the eye. So I'm just sweeping it after everything runs off. Just sweep the table into the vial. And there's lots of micro gold there. Nice piece. Get some more. Can't believe how much gold is just in 2 gallons of material. There's the vial. That's how much gold we got in there. We got well over a gram, a couple grams right there. That was a nice paint off.
Okay, time for a recap. We ran a couple gallons of material through the high banker, the geo sluice, and down in through the Black Mamba mat that we made out of silicone, and we have vibrator on it. And we cleaned out the tailings. We only got 2 pieces of gold that were any decent size, and then we got a couple micro pieces. And that's because at one point I was overloading the mat a little bit. I think that's why that went. We caught that in the tailings. Anyways, then we cleaned the mats out. And we ran them through the hex mat and put them on the Miller table. And you saw all the gold we got there. There was more gold in 2 gallons of material here from that creek than we've had on any other spot or any other creek all summer. And it might be contributed to the vibrator on there. I think that's catching more of the gold in the mat with that vibrator It drops it down the riffles, washes out that light stuff. So that was very impressive. So we're very happy with our results. So we're just gonna continue running our buckets through that, the way it's set up right now with the vibration, the way it is, and do our cleanups and see how much it improves. So I hope you like the video, and hit that like button, share, subscribe if you haven't already, and may the gold years sluice be plentiful, and we will see you next time.